Welcome to Worship with Tibbetts United Methodist Church. I'm Jalice.
And I'm Estelle.
The service has been recorded for Sunday, April 18th, 2021. The disciples experienced the risen Christ among them, and the Gospel of John reads, "While in their joy they were disbelieving and still wondering." We too experience wonder and disbelief when confronted with new life. Let us pray as we center ourselves for this time of worship. Living God, break through the disappointments and disillusionments that send us home sad and silent. You who toss boulders from the mouths of tombs like pebbles into a river, touch us this day with ripples and resurrection joy. The news is too good not to be true, that nothing in life or in death can impede your vitality from reaching and raising us from death to abundant life. In this hour of worship, help us to recognize the risen one in our midst, that our hearts might stir once more with possibilities of resurrection and fresh songs of hope. Amen.
Amen.
Please join us in the call to worship. God of history and of our hearts, help us believe in new beginnings. And in our beginning again, no matter how often we've failed. Help us to make new beginnings. To begin going out of our weary minds into fresh dreams, daring to make our own bold tracks in the land of the now. to begin forgiving that we may experience mercy, to begin questioning the unquestionable that we may know truth, to begin disciplining that we may create beauty, to begin sacrificing that we may accomplish justice, to begin risking that we may make peace, to begin loving that we may realize joy. Help us to believe in new beginnings, to be a witness to the new life unfolding in and through us.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. To see you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing all.
Sarah and baby Esther, and today I want to talk to you about being part of a community. Now, what is a community? A community is a group of people who have something in common. And at Tibbetts, we are a community, and the thing we share and that we have in common is that we're all seeking to be disciples of Jesus, to know God and to grow in our understanding of God. Everyone in our community plays a role. When we come to worship, we play a part in our community. When we pray for one another, we play a part in our community. When we take care of each other, we play a part in our community. And even baby Esther plays a part in our community. Now, I know what you're thinking. How can a baby play a part in our community? She can't walk, she can't talk, she can't read. What can she do? When I look at Esther, I am reminded that we are all human beings and we all need to eat and we need to sleep and we need a safe place to live. And when I look at Esther, I'm reminded when she cries that there is pain in the world, when she laughs that there is joy in the world. Just by her showing up and being who she is, even as a baby, she plays a part in our community by reminding me, reminding all of us what it means to be human and what it means to be made in the image of God. Now, sometimes I get distracted by all the things I have to do and I forget to pay attention to the people in our community. When I'm not paying attention, I miss all the reminders of God's presence around us. Our role as disciples in the Tibbetts community is to pay attention to ourselves and to one another. And when we pay attention, we see the needs of one another and of our community, and we see God's Spirit at work. And we learn how we can help each other through our prayers, our presence, our gifts, our service, and our witness. My prayer is that as Esther grows, she would learn to pay attention to her community and that she would understand the role that she plays in our community, sharing her gifts, shaping who we are as a church. And this is my prayer for each and every one of us who calls Tibbetts our home. Will you pray with me? Okay, honey, we're gonna pray. Let's pray. God, remind us that we are all part of a community. Help us to pay attention so we don't miss what you are up to, and so that we know how to love and help one another as you love and help us. Amen. Over the last few months, the nominations and leadership development team have been working to help members identify their gifts and discern how God is inviting each and every one of us to contribute to and shape our community life together. In the coming weeks, we will be onboarding new leaders, those who have said yes and responded to God's call to serve, and introducing them to all of you. We'll also be taking time to thank those who are stepping down or changing roles. I wanted to let you know that 2 spots remain open to serve on each of the Finance, Trustees, and Staff Parish Relations Committees. The role of the Nominations and Leadership Development Team is to discern, guide, and support every member of the community in their service and participation in the life of our church. But it's up to each one of us to explore how we can make meaningful contributions to Tibbetts. If you missed the Thursday announcements this past week, I invite you to take a moment to read that email, and the announcements are also posted on our website under News and Events. There you will find more information about how you can participate, as well as the Invitation to Serve survey to help you explore possibilities for service within our church. Thank you for your continued commitments to Tibbetts through your prayers, your presence, your gifts, your service, and your witness.
Good morning. Our first scripture reading this morning comes from the book of Acts, chapter 3, verses 12 through 19. When Peter saw it, he addressed the people, "You Israelites, why do you wonder at this? Or why do you stare at us as though by our own power or piety we had made him walk? The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our ancestors, has glorified his servant Jesus, who you handed over and rejected in the presence of Pilate, though he had decided to release him. But you rejected the holy and righteous one and asked to have a murderer given to you. And you killed the author of life, whom God raised from the dead. To this we are witnesses. And by faith in his name itself has made this man strong, whom you see and know, and the faith that is through Jesus has given him this perfect health in the presence of all of you. And now, friends, I know that you acted in ignorance, as did also your rulers. In this way, God fulfilled what he had foretold through all the prophets, that his Messiah would suffer. Repent, therefore, and turn to God, that your sins may be wiped out."
When we share our gifts, ministry happens. The wide variety of ministries at Tibbetts are made possible through contributions of members and friends, praying for one another, being present in our community, offering financial support, and serving through outreach. You participate in the life of Tibbetts by sharing your gifts through worship, Bible study, joining our Zoom fellowship time, volunteering for outreach missions, and financial giving. You can give financially online or mail a check to the Church Financial Secretary at 3940 41st Avenue Southwest, 98116. Today, we give thanks for the music of John Van Lierop and Shirley Lindeberg as they play "Crown Him with Many Crowns."
The second reading today comes from the book of Luke, chapter 24, verses 36b through 48. While they were talking about this, Jesus himself stood among them and said to them, "Peace be with you." They were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. He said to them, "Why are you frightened? And why do doubts arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet. See that it is I myself. Touch me and see, for a ghost does not have flesh and bones as you see that I have." And when he had said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While in their joy they were disbelieving and still wondering, he said to them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of broiled fish, and he took it and ate it in their presence. Then he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things."
Will you pray with me? May the words of my mouth, the meditations of all our hearts, be acceptable to you, O God, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. Amen. You are witnesses of these things. Jesus tells the disciples that they are witnesses. What is a witness, and what makes a good witness? A good witness is someone who remembers the details. A witness remembers what they've seen, what they've experienced, and they can give a testimony. They can tell the story. In order to remember the details, you have to have been paying attention. And we know that this is easier said than done because we live in a world that is full of distractions. We are constantly navigating the circumstances of our lives, trying to remain fully present while also anticipating and preparing for the future. It's a balancing act, and we know from experience that it can be quite difficult. Perhaps this is why the practice of mindfulness is so important. We must seek to quiet our hearts in order to listen, in order to hear, to practice an intentional pause, drawing attention to all of our senses in order to ground ourselves in the present moment. Engaging our senses heightens our awareness of what's happening within us and around us. Throughout the Gospels, we see over and over again Jesus calling the disciples to attention, inviting them to open their eyes, their ears, their minds, their hearts, to become aware of God's presence, to pay attention to detail. And Jesus shows them what to look for. He opens their minds to the scriptures. We are in the season of Easter, post-resurrection. Jesus visits the disciples, and the text tells us that they were startled and terrified. They thought that they had seen a ghost. Interesting that those disciples witnessed the empty tomb, experienced the resurrection, and they are still surprised when Jesus shows up among them. So surprised, in fact, that they can't believe it. Doubts arise in their hearts about what they've seen and what they've experienced. I think the journey and celebration and ritual of Lent, Holy Week, and Easter lead us to believe that once we experience the resurrection, everything will instantly be different. We will be different. And it's true that nothing will ever be the same. So why were the disciples responding this way to the presence of the risen Christ among them?
Why do we still feel like we're living in the wilderness, even though it's Easter, even though we've experienced the resurrection? We often believe change should be and is instantaneous. And even when a single event takes place that alters the direction of our lives, it takes time for us to fully live into the newness. This is especially true if the event was traumatic. We do not turn a page and suddenly know how to be Easter people. It's an ongoing transformation that requires us to continually pay attention and to remember those details of what we have experienced. Consider a resurrection experience in your own life, a time when you made a decision to live your life anew, or a time when you experienced a turning point towards the light after a season of darkness and despair. We often assume change comes from an outside force, but Jesus teaches us that change comes from within. In Acts 3, Peter heals a man outside the temple gates. The people who witness this take place are astonished, and Peter draws their attention to the presence of God in that moment as the source of the healing that occurred. And he does this by reminding them of what happened. That Jesus was betrayed, handed over, and killed, and God raised him from the dead. And Peter says to the people, "To this we are witnesses." Peter recalls the details of the crucifixion and resurrection of Jesus. He gives testimony. He tells the story. Of course, there is to be reflection on the events that have taken place and reflection on the role that we played in that moment. Hindsight is 20/20. There are things we can only see and know about an experience when we look back. Things that were not clear in the moment are revealed as life unfolds and time passes. Perhaps this is why, as witnesses, we are called to constantly remember. To remember what's happened to us, to remember what God has done, to recall how we have experienced God's grace throughout our lives, and to testify, to tell the story, and to tell it over and over and over again with our very lives. So when we find ourselves in the pit of despair, wondering where God is, if there is any grace to be found in our suffering, we remember the ways God was faithful to us in the past. We remember God's grace. And this helps us to know that God's grace is present with us even now, though we cannot see it. This, my friends, is faith. Trusting that God's grace is real and with us, even when we can't see it, even when we can't perceive it. And it's in the valleys of our lives that we come to fully know that grace. And it's in the season of resurrection that we come to realize God's grace was there in the valley with us. In the coming weeks, we will read scripture recalling the teachings of Jesus to the disciples to know God, to abide in God, to love others as God has loved us. We will learn how to live as Easter people. May God be with us as we witness the movement of the Spirit within us and among us. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Sit and weep, was the night. continue to God in prayer, will you pray with me? God of new life, though we have witnessed the resurrection, we still struggle to understand how to live as Easter people. The truth is, we still witness violence in our world. We still witness suffering, and we still struggle to find grace in the now. Our hearts break, our voices cry out for the injustice that ensues, for the life of Dante Wright, for the lives of all those murdered at the hands of those called to protect, for the Black and Brown and Asian and transgender human beings whose lives were taken from their families, their communities, from our world. It seems thoughts and prayers are not enough, O God. It seems like awareness of our own privilege and the ways we are complicit in perpetuating oppression is not enough. It even seems like repentance is not enough. So we ask you, O God, show us the way. Guide our hearts and minds. Transform us, change us, move us, shape us, shake us awake. Open our eyes to the reality of suffering and violence, and in our seeing, make us new. We remain anxious about the future, wondering what tomorrow will bring. Call us back to the present. Engage our senses that we would be aware of the presence of the risen Christ among us. Give us the courage to resist the urgency of our world so that we could pay attention to the details before us. Show us your hands so that we may reach out to mend the broken. Show us your feet so that we may walk with those the world passes by. Show us your face so that we may know we are made in your image. Risen Christ, touch us with your compassion. Open our eyes so we may see God's love. Open our minds so we may welcome God's word. Open our lips so we may be God's witnesses. Spirit of hope, touch us with your peace. May we know ourselves to be instruments of God's healing in our world. We pray for those among us who are grieving the loss of loved ones, who are navigating the waters of depression and shame, those who are experiencing physical illness whose bodies have betrayed them. Pour out your spirit of peace that passes understanding. God and community, open us to your presence as we pray the prayer that Jesus taught us.
Our Father and Mother,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come.
Thy will be done.
On earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread.
And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory,
forever and ever. Amen. Hi, I'm Betsy Wharton, and here are some announcements before the benediction. From Pastor Sarah, there are some important conversations taking place in our faith community right now, and the letter published in the April 15th announcements email has information on our church leadership, the work of the reimagining team, and our faith and hope during these challenging times. I hope everyone will take a few moments to read and be informed on what is happening in the life of our church. From the welcome team, we are continuing to share reflection questions each week and seek your thoughts around our worship series. Please refer to the weekly announcements email on Thursday and in the Sunday morning worship email, and join us any Sunday at 11 a.m. for our fellowship time. We're excited to hear from you. From the relationship team, we know COVID-19 vaccinations are available to anyone 16 and older now, And for those who need a safe ride to get to an appointment, our spirit movers are happy to provide one. Please contact Charlie Shelfer or Ben Allen White. If you need help scheduling your vaccination, please call or email the church office. There are many reasons to visit the church website, TibbettsUMChurch.org. We publish the latest events, worship services, and ways to connect with your Tibbetts family. The worship tab on the left side is where you can see all of the worship videos, past and present. On the news and events tab, there are posts about all of the current activities with Zoom links for each of them. Every Sunday, we have fellowship at 11 a.m. and every Wednesday, we have Bible study at 10 a.m. On the subscribe tab, you can see how to receive our weekly announcements emails, which are sent out on Thursday afternoons. It's a great way to stay in touch with your Tibbetts family and the news of the church. The Give tab shows how you can donate to Tibbetts online. If you have a prayer request that you would like shared in a worship video, please email the church office and let us know. If you would like to be added to the prayer chain, please let us know that, and we will be glad to include you there. Have a wonderful day and a blessed week ahead. Bye.
Summer and winter and springtime and autumn.
everything good begins to feel out of reach, when collective change seems impossible, or hope and grace are simply hard to find, Christ whispers to us, peace, peace among us, not to dull our need to feel sorrow or to quell necessary conflict, but to remind us again of what is so easily forgotten. Evil has not overtaken us. Love is still alive. God is potential, always with us. To this we are witnesses. May God's peace sustain us as we go with confidence. Thanks be to God. Amen.